It's intimidating to go into a patient's room live for the first time, and everybody wants to go in equipped and knowledgeable, and the opportunity to work that out in simulation really provides that.
The Deborah Spunt Simulation Lab started in 1998. And it started as a vision of a simulation pioneer, Deborah L. Spunt. And this was one of the first nursing schools to have a simulation lab of this extent.
There is a disconnect between the mind and the body. And even though they can read through it and understand it intellectually, to be able to do it with their hands and to really apply the things that they're learning takes a lot of practice.
Our goal is really to be able to have our students graduate from our programs and feel comfortable that when they are given certain situations, whether they've experienced it or not, that they are able to tackle it because they have had opportunities to practice in an environment where they have been able to learn from it and then reapply it later on.
Even if you haven't done it in the real world, you've done it in simulation, you've done it in lab, so you feel more confident.
Here in simulation lab, I know it's a learning experience, and whatever we do here, it's all to help us as clinicians and as advanced practice nurses.
We currently here at University of Maryland are replacing approximately 10% of the clinical hours for our entry to practice students with simulation. And the graduate level simulation opportunities are not as common in nursing education. And so I think that is one of the areas that we really do also excel.
It kind of brings more of a community between you and your instructor. You get more time to spend time together and learn their expectations, and they learn your strengths, and you kind of understand each other better before you go out into the community in the hospitals.
They are apprehensive, they do want to do a good job, they are intelligent, they are motivated to learn, and to sort of help them to remove this apprehension of they have to do it perfectly and they have to do it right. You know, that it's okay and necessary that we practice and that we practice repetitively to become competent in a skill.
It is a learning experience. At the end of each simulation, we do a debriefing with our clinical instructor, and we can talk about what went well, what didn't go well, and then we can take whatever we've learned from the simulation and then apply that in our clinical practice site in an acute care setting.
I envision that in about 20 years, we will have simulation centers that have hospital units, that have a simulated pharmacy, that have a simulated lab. And then we bring all of these professions together and we have an amazingly robust debriefing conversation and learn how to work with, from, and around each other.